I guess, Tori, you didn't see it go up, huh?
Yeah, hey guys, here on the Treasure Coast, specifically in Fort Pierce, it was just too cloudy for people to see the shuttle launch. There were hundreds of people along the jetty here in Fort Pierce, so honestly, there were kids who had never seen this, and then there were people who had seen dozens of these shuttle launches. I'm going to take you kind of through a step-by-step of the emotions this morning.
For the last 30 years, I've lived, eaten, breathed, so I want to see one before, you know, this is the last one to see.
People are watching history from a distance at the Fort Pierce Jetty, a popular spot some 90 miles south of Cape Canaveral.
On the Treasure Coast, where you don't have to be around a million people, it's sad.
I'm excited. I'm on cloud heaven right now, waiting for the concussion to hit my chest, hopefully, to feel my heart beating.
For the past 30 years, people have been coming here to watch history happen. In fact, some of the spectators can actually pinpoint the spot where the shuttle flies over. But today, these launches are history themselves.
Disappointing. I've seen two other shuttles, and this one was kind of sad for the last one.
Did it go up? Didn't see anything.
Saw the trail go right through the clouds. Little window.
It's the end of something, and I hope the beginning of something. Ever since I was watching Captain Kirk a long time ago, I was waiting for these guys to go faster than the speed of light.
If we look at what history has taught us, who knows, this end of an era could be the beginning of time for next generation astronauts in search of
planets and the stars.
All right, so you heard it right there. Who knows what the future holds? And I want to tell you guys, one of the interesting things that was said out here after the shuttle launch, this guy walked by and he said, you know, we can't control what we can see, that they're just happy that those astronauts got up to space.
So true. Tori Dunn and live in Fort Pierce.